Today, cameras like the Sony FX6 offer onboard seamless variable ND filters with an automatic function. Now that's a lot of features: onboard, variable, seamless, and automatic. So what are some of the best uses for this tool? Well, today I'll show you how I use the auto function on my variable ND filters in two different situations. ND filters, or neutral density filters, are basically sunglasses for your lenses. They come in many different forms and strength. Some are circular filters that can be threaded to the front of your lens, some can be filters that fit inside of a matte box, and others are on board, or part of the camera, sitting between the lens and the sensor. They come in different strength, measured in optical density, but uses an ND factor for easy reference, like an ND4 or an ND16 or 128. The bigger the number, the darker the filter is. Some filters are variable, meaning one filter can be adjusted to different ND level, removing the need to buy multiple filters. Variable ND filters are also seamless, meaning they're not hard stop. They will gradually go between the stops. You use ND filters to control the amount of light coming into the camera in order to maintain other camera settings. So for example, if you want to shoot outdoor with a wide open aperture and want to leave your shutter speed at a fixed settings, you can use ND filters to control exposure. It's like an extra camera setting to use, allowing you to still be creative with your images and achieve correct exposure. I recently shot a job for a client and ran into a unique situation where not only did I need to use my ND filters, but for the first time decided to use the automatic function of the variable ND filters on board my Sony FX6. I needed to shoot an interview inside this room. The room had plenty of daylight coming in, but because everything was plain white, I decided to use two lamps on each side of the fireplace with a warmer color temperature to break the flatness of the white wall. Now, in order to eliminate the flickering from the light bulb, I had to set and keep my shutter speed at 1/60th of a second. I always try to shoot everything fully open to get a shallow depth of field, so I set my aperture to 1.3, and I used my ND filters to limit the amount of light to achieve correct exposure. So far, so good, nothing special. But a couple minutes into the interview, the room became dark very quickly. A cloud had just moved in rapidly, and now my shot was underexposed. So here you can see that I tried to lower the ND filter on the fly to restore correct exposure. I'm doing that by turning the dial on my ND filter while looking at the false color on my monitor at the same time as the person is answering the question. At that point, I know I'll need to cover my adjustment with B-roll if I ever want to use this soundbite, but the reality is that the underexposed shot was completely unusable, so I'd rather fix it quickly. Now the issue is the cloud moved out as soon as it came in, and all of a sudden the light level in the room kept moving back and forth as more clouds kept rolling in and out. Now after adjusting it a couple of times, I decided to turn the auto function on, letting the camera seamlessly adjust the level of ND filters to keep the correct exposure. You may ask, why not keep your camera in auto exposure instead? Well, by using the ND filter, I get to keep the look and feel that I want, with the fully open aperture for my shallow depth of field, and my shutter speed set to make sure that those lights don't flicker. The auto function of the ND filter is very responsive and just a great option when you're experiencing uncontrollable variable lighting condition. That same day, I decided to try using the auto function for another situation that I've been wanting to experiment with for a while now: long exposure time lapse, going from daytime to nighttime. Long exposure just in order to get those nice light streak from the cars, but starting during the day and continuing throughout nightfall. Using the auto ND filter function, the camera should decrease the amount of ND as the night falls, creating a seamless time lapse. For this test, I wanted to see how long of an exposure I could set in broad daylight. With my ND filter set to automatic, I lowered my shutter speed until the camera set the ND to its maximum value of 128. You can see that I'm able to have a shutter as low as 32 frames or just above 1.3 seconds. I can now set my interval so that the camera will take one image every 2 seconds and stay open and exposed for 1.3 seconds. With all my settings ready, I can just push the record button and wait it for the night to fall. There are two things that I would have done differently on this shot. First, I started a little too late. Sunset is already on the way, so the colors have already faded. It would have been nice to start maybe 15 minutes earlier with a nice, bright, colorful shot. The other issue to keep in mind when doing daytime to nighttime time lapse is the white balance. We know that daylight has a color temperature of around 56K, but nighttime public artificial lighting is often more around 40K. So I wanted to set my white balance to automatic, but with the Sony FX6 in Cine EI mode, that function is simply not available. So I set my white balance to 41K, knowing that I would need to adjust it in post to gradually change from 56 to 41. But I'm happy with the result. I was able to achieve long exposure enough to have some nice good light streaks, and the transition from daylight to nightlight is smooth. Of course, this was probably the only time that the Union train station in Kansas City experienced some electrical malfunction and the lights suddenly shut off before eventually coming back on. But that's the game we play when filming anything with very little control. The good thing is I'm scheduled to travel back to Kansas City soon for yet another job, so I'm pretty sure that I'll be back and shoot this again just to see if I can improve on this first test. Now, having onboard seamless variable automatic ND filters is just a great feature that allows me to maintain creative control in uncontrollable situations. Now, I hope this video was helpful, and please feel free to share your experience with ND filters. Thank you for watching this video until the end. As a token of my appreciation, I'd like to offer you my free camera setting cheat sheet. Just follow the link below to download the free cheat sheet. Thanks again, and happy filming.